Good morning, Montfortians. Today we are going to start with our next topic, that is mole concept. Mole concept idea was given by Avogadro's, but later on, after so many researches on this, then Oswald was the scientist who told us about mole. He said mole is nothing but it is a quantity like 1 dozen, 1 score, and 1 gross. As we know, 1 dozen contains 12 article, 1 score contains 20 article, and 1 gross contains 144 articles. Like this, Oswald said 1 mole will contain 6.022 × 10⁻²³ articles or entities. And entities can be atoms, molecule, or ions. Entities can be atoms, molecule, or ions. And this number is known as Avogadro's number. This number is known as Avogadro's number. Now, according to this, 1 mole of sodium, 1 mole of sodium will be equals to 6.022 × 10⁻²³ atoms of sodium. Why atoms? Because sodium exists in atomic form. If I'll write 1 mole of hydrogen, then it will be equals to 6.022 × 10⁻²³ molecules of hydrogen. Why molecules? Because hydrogen exists in a molecular form. Then 1 mole of carbon dioxide will be equals to 6.022 × 10⁻²³ molecule of carbon dioxide. Why? Because carbon dioxide is also exist in a molecular form. Now, if I want to write 1 mole of oleum, oleum is H2S2O7, it will be equals to 6.022 × 10⁻²³ molecules of oleum. Now, if I want to calculate number of atoms from these, then we have to multiply Avogadro's number with its atomicity. So, if I want to calculate number of atoms in first case, then atomicity of sodium is 1, then number of atoms is equals to 1 × 6.022 × 10⁻²³. If I want to calculate number of atoms in second case, then the atomicity of hydrogen is 2. Then number of atoms is equals to 2 × 6.022 × 10⁻²³. If I want to calculate number of atoms in third case, then the atomicity of third case is, or CO2 is 3. The number of atoms is equals to 3 × 6.022 × 10⁻²³. Now, if I want to calculate number of atoms in fourth case, then atomicity of oleum is 11. Then number of atoms is equals to 11 × 6.022 × 10⁻²³. Now, let's see how we can calculate number of moles. There are three methods to calculate number of moles. First, if mass is given in question, the number of moles are equals to given mass of substance upon molecular mass. For example, calculate number of moles in 64 gram of oxygen. The number of moles is equals to given mass upon molecular mass. Given mass is 64 and molecular mass of oxygen is 32. The answer is 2. Calculate number of moles of 12 gram of carbon. Number of moles is equals to given mass upon molecular mass. Given mass is 12 gram and molecular mass of carbon is also 12. The answer is 1. Second method, if number of particles are given in question, the number of moles is equals to number of particles given upon Avogadro's number. For example, calculate number of moles in 3.01 into 10 raised to the power 23 molecules of carbon dioxide. Now, here you can see number of particles are given. The number of moles is equals to number of particles upon Avogadro's number. Number of particles are 3.01 into 10 raised to the power 23. And Avogadro's number is 6.022 into 10 raised to the power 23. 10 raised to the power 23 will cut 10 raised to the power 23 and the answer is 0.5. Third method, if volume is given in question, the number of moles is equals to volume given upon 22.4. For example, calculate number of moles in 11.2 liter of oxygen. Here you can see volume is given. Then number of moles is equals to volume given upon 22.4. Volume given is 11.2. upon 22.4. The answer is 0.5. Now come to next topic, that is percentage composition. As you know, each molecule is made up of atoms. For example, water. Water is made up of hydrogen and oxygen. And percentage composition means how much hydrogen is present in water and how much oxygen is present in water. Formula to calculate percentage composition of each element is atomic mass of element upon molecular mass of compound into 100. Now we can calculate one by one how much hydrogen is present in water and how much oxygen is present in water, or the percentage composition of hydrogen and oxygen in water one by one. So the percentage composition of hydrogen is atomic mass of hydrogen upon molecular mass of compound, molecular mass of compound into 100. Now molecular mass of compound, that is water, is equals to 18. Then percentage of hydrogen is equals to atomic mass of hydrogen, that is 1, and how many hydrogen atoms? 2 upon molecular mass of compound is 18 into 100, that is 11.11%. And percentage of oxygen is equals to 100 minus percentage of hydrogen, that is 11.11. It will be equals to 88.89%. Now let's see second question. Calculate the percentage of carbon and oxygen in CO2. First of all, we have to calculate molecular mass of carbon dioxide, that is 44. Now percentage composition of carbon is equals to atomic mass of carbon, that is 12, and how many carbon atoms? Only 1. Upon molecular mass of compound, that is 44 into 100, and it will be equals to 27.2%. Now if we have calculated percentage of one component, then we can calculate percentage of other component like this: 100 minus 27.2, and it will be equals to 72.8%. Now come to third question, that is calculate percentage composition of sodium, oxygen and hydrogen in sodium hydroxide. For this, first of all, we have to calculate molecular mass of sodium hydroxide, and molecular mass of sodium hydroxide is 40. Now percentage composition of sodium is equals to atomic mass of sodium, that is 23, and molar mass of sodium hydroxide is 40 into 100. And that will be equals to 57.5%. Now percentage composition of oxygen will be equals to atomic mass of oxygen, that is 16, upon molecular mass of sodium hydroxide, that is 40 into 100, and it will be equals to 40. Now percentage composition of hydrogen, how we can calculate? 100 minus addition of these two, that is 57.5 plus 40 is equals to 100 minus 90 7.5, that will be equals to 2.5%. I hope you all have understood these numericals. If you have understood, try to find out the percentage composition of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen in glucose. Now the next topic is empirical and molecular formula. Empirical formula is the simplest whole number ratio of all the elements present in a compound. For example, glucose. Glucose is C6H12O6. And if I'll calculate the simplest whole number ratio, then it will be 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 ones are 6. The ratio is 1:2:1. And the empirical formula will be C1H2O1, that is CH2O. And come to molecular formula. Molecular formula is a chemical formula that tells us how many atoms of each element are present in a compound. For example, in glucose, 6 atoms of carbon are present, 12 atoms of hydrogen are present, and 6 atoms of oxygen are present. So the molecular formula of glucose is C6H12O6. Now let's see the numerical based on empirical formula and molecular formula. Calculate empirical formula and molecular formula if the molecular mass of an organic compound is 78 and percentage composition of carbon is 92.4% and hydrogen is 7.6%. We will solve these numericals by drawing a table. In first column, we will write element. In this question, what are the elements? Carbon and hydrogen. In second column, we will write percentage. Carbon percentage is 92.4% and hydrogen percentage is 7.6. In third column, we will write atomic mass. Carbon atomic mass is 12 and hydrogen atomic mass is 1. In the fourth column, we will calculate number of moles. Number of moles we can calculate by dividing percentage with the atomic mass. So, number of moles of carbon will be 92.4 divided by 12. And it will be equals to 7.7. Number of moles of hydrogen will be 7.6 divided by 1. It is equals to 7.6. Out of these two, whichever will be the smaller value, you have to divide both of these with that value. So let's see, in this 7.6 is the smaller value. So we will divide these two with the 7.6. Now 7.7 divided by 7.6, it will be approximately equals to 1. 7.6 divided by 7.6 is equals to 1. Now the simplest whole number ratio is 1 and 1. So the empirical formula is C1H1, that is CH. Now we want to calculate molecular formula. And the formula to calculate molecular formula is N into empirical formula. Now what is N? N is molecular mass upon empirical formula mass. Molecular mass is given in a question, that is 78, and empirical formula mass is 13. So N is 78 upon 13 and it is equals to 6. Now let us put the value of N in molecular formula. Molecular formula is equals to 6 into empirical formula. 6 into empirical formula is CH, that is C6H6. So the molecular formula is C6H6. Sometime in a question, in place of molecular mass, vapor density is given. Then we can calculate molecular mass with this formula, 2 into vapor density. That's all for today. Have a nice day ahead.